Patients with age-related macular degeneration require frequent injections in order to maintain their vision. The injections of anti-VEGF therapy work very well, but patients have to come in 8, 9, 10 times per year indefinitely. And so the unmet need is really to transform those 8 to 10 visits into perhaps a one and you're done. And it would be nice if that one and you're done was done in the office. And that's where ADVM-022 comes in. ADVM-022 is a gene therapy that delivers aflibercept. Aflibercept is a medication that we use routinely in our patients with macular degeneration. With ADVM-022, we inject the medication into the eye, and the gene therapy allows the eye itself to make the aflibercept protein. With the aflibercept protein being made in the eye, there's really no need for intravitreal injections. In the OPTIC trial, which is a phase 1, 2-year, multi-center prospective clinical trial, we injected ADVM-022 in patients who required injections for wet AMD. In those patients, on average, they needed about 35 injections prior to enrolling in OPTIC. These patients were also not treatment naive, on average about 3.5 years of diagnosis of wet AMD before they enrolled. In the first subjects, in the first 6 subjects that were enrolled in cohort 1, we reported the 24-week data. With robust anatomical response, with maintaining visual acuity, patients did not require any rescue injections. Here, we report even newer data. The follow-up out to October 1st. The follow-up through October 1st, on average, was about 8 months. One of the patients in the study was followed for over 10 months. The anatomical responses that we saw in the 6-month data continue out to the last follow-up. Patients did not require any injections, and they maintained their vision. They also maintained the improvements on OCT. So when you think about how gene therapy, specifically gene therapy with ADVM-022, can transform this landscape, it can take patients who require frequent injections and turn it into a potential one-and-done therapy. One of the subjects, our patients in the trial, interestingly, required 109 injections prior to enrollment. Since receiving the gene therapy, this particular patient has not required any rescue injections with nearly 9-month follow-up. Now, these are 6 patients in the first cohort of the OPTIC trial. More definitely needs to be done, but with a safety profile that we're seeing, which is favorable, and with the efficacy profile that we're seeing, I think within the next 3 to 5 years, we can expect gene therapy with anti-VEGF in the office treating our patients who now require frequent injections.